Thank you for your patience and cooperation. Boarding will begin in a few moments.
YouTube, and welcome, Phriq here, and I am back for episode 3 of my Let's Play Flight Simulator X FS Passengers Season 5 video series. As you can see, we are sitting in the lovely Carenado brown and yellow Cessna 152 here in sunny Devil's Lake, North Dakota, which is actually a little cloudy right now. The weather is kind of iffy in spots. There might be a little bit of precipitation, but I'm hoping not. I will get into the weather a little later. As you know, last flight we dropped off a fisherman here who was hopefully catching some delicious walleye and northern pike on their fishing excursion, but today we are going to be taking another fisherman back to their hometown, which is Jamestown, North Dakota, which is 71 nautical miles to the south. Estimated time and route, we're looking at about 44 minutes. As you can see, I got for my visual flight plan right here using my aeronautical chart on SkyVector that we are going to be departing from KDVL and going to KJMS. The speed we're looking at is 85 knots again at an altitude of 055, which is 5,500 feet. Because we're going to be doing a slightly easterly heading. Distance is going to be 72 nautical miles, roughly, in an estimated time and route of 44 minutes. As far as visual flight rules go, we are going to be doing no navigation outside. Well, not, we're going to be doing navigation, but we're not going to be using any nav aids outside of our heading. So we're going to pretty much be flying a heading of 170. We're going to cross Devil's Lake. Off our left wing for most of the flight, you're going to see all these little lakes that go north to south. We're going to be looking off our left wing, following them down until we get to this larger lake, which we can hopefully see. I'm hoping the game depicts that. And then you can also see that there's a large power line running here with a road. Once we get past that, you are going to be seeing Jamestown Reservoir right here, which is about a 30 nautical mile reservoir from the James River being dammed, I guess. I don't know how else to put that. And that's kind of going to be like our flashlight pointing to our destination, which is going to be Jamestown, North Dakota, with the airport just on the northeast side. Looking at the weather, going into AirNav, you can see the real world METAR, and I am using Active Sky Next again, so I am using live weather and live time. It's roughly 8:30 p.m., so hopefully it doesn't get too dark before we get there. The weather right now is 340 at 7 knots, 10 statute miles of visibility, overcast at 10,000 feet. Other than that, everything is looking fairly okay. There's some more overcast and things like that. It is predicted to get a little windier, but I'm not too worried about that as of right now, because that's on the 10th. Next, we're going into AirNav for Jamestown, North Dakota, and you can see it is 330 at 7 knots, 10 statute miles. Visibility overcast at 11,000 feet. The TAF is showing some light rain showers, overcast at 6,000, so I'm hoping we don't run into any of that. So that is our flight plan. We are going to do this hell or high water. Let's go ahead and get into the aircraft and start some checklists. But before we do that, we should probably start a flight. So I'm going to go into FS Passengers and I'm going to start flight. There are two passengers ready and willing to fly with us, which is kind of unbelievable on account that we only have one extra seat. They're making me answer this again. There are two seats in this aircraft. Whatever, we're going to go ahead and close that. So we're going to go ahead and put that one passenger in. That passenger's name is going to be Catalina Quinn, age 39. I hope you had a wonderful fishing trip. She is also a lighter girl, so we only have 84%. Our max fuel, we're at 59%, and I'm actually going to leave it there. We're going to run a little low towards the end, but we should definitely have enough fuel to get there. This way, we can add a little more cargo, because this person hauled in the fish, probably. I don't even think this plane can carry 60 pounds of cargo. We're just going to say there's 50 pounds. It's her luggage and all that delicious fish that she got. So we got a aircraft load of 93%. Set destination, we are going to be going to KJMS. And the flight duration, we are going to say that it is going to take us a lovely, balmy 44 minutes. Hopefully that holds up. We are going to have to take off to the north, so it is going to take us a few minutes to circle around Devil's Lake, but whatever. We're just going to go with whatever SkyVector said, because I don't want to do any more planning than that. Next, we're going to select the flight type, and that's going to be a normal flight. So let's go ahead and do that. Set flight type, and then we're going to do a real-time load. So, okay, it's going to take 2 minutes. I got you right there. I'm not going to be really paying attention to any of that. So I'm going to hit Shift-E and start lettering the passenger climb over me, because the door is still over there. As they are getting, well, she is already aboard. So we're just going to go ahead and turn on the seatbelt sign, and which we wouldn't even have in this aircraft, and then close the door. With that being said, I'm going to go into my checklist. I am using a different checklist. However, I am releasing this video in correlation with a Let's Learn video on a cold and dark startup of the Cessna 152. So if you want to see more detail on starting and using the Cessna 152, definitely go in and check out that video. I'm going to be skipping all the initial stuff, so I'm going straight into the start checklist. Seat track back is locked. Avionics are off. Carb heat is hopefully off. Let's get rid of these yokes, because, again, no one needs to use those when they're flying. We can fly telepathically these days, or remotely. We're just going to get rid of those. Carb heat is pushed in, so it is off. Beacon is going to come to the on position at this time. Mixture, we're going to go full rich. And throttle, we're going to crack that slightly, about a quarter of an inch. As you can see, prime, 1, 2, 3. We have primed. Brakes are on. We are ready to check the prop. Prop clear. Looking both ways, I see no vehicles, no personnel, and we are ready to start the engine. So I'm going to go to the mags and turn those to, what am I doing? I got to turn the master switch on first. Why are my flaps coming down? That doesn't make any sense. Those flaps should be up. Now they are up. I have no idea what's going on. I think there is a button somewhere mapped on my keyboard that I am pressing that is making my flaps go down. I'm going to have to figure that out before the next flight. We are going to go ahead and start our engine. As you can see, the engine is starting. Oil pressure is starting to come alive. So is the oil temperature. As you can see, we had the throttle perfect because it's sitting at a lovely 1000 RPM, which is right where we want it. Mixture as required. We're going to keep it full rich because we are low enough in altitude. Let's go into the pre-taxi checklist. First, I'm going to turn on my alternator master switch, and then I'm going to turn on my avionics and get those set up. So flaps are up, heat vent defrost. Nah, it's a beautiful day. We don't need that. Avionics are on. Let's go ahead and listen to the ATIS, or the automated weather for Devil's Lake. Alright, we are going to be using runway 31 today, since the winds are 325 at 5. I do have an airport diagram now of Devil's Lake, so I'm going to be using that as well, even though if I look off my left, stop doing that game. If I look off my left wing, you can see that if I taxi right there, there is runway 31. That is the end of it, so that is where we're going to go. It's going to be a pretty simple taxi. Altimeter is set. Radios have been kind of tested, but we don't really have anybody to talk to unless we start talking about traffic, but we don't even know if anybody's on this frequency, so we're just going to go with it. Taxi light we do not have, so we can't even do that. Brakes are going to be tested. Altitude, our attitude indicator, turn coordinator, and HI compass are also going to be tested as we do this. So with that being said, we have one passenger wearing our seatbelt. Let's go ahead and start our taxi. I'm going to get rid of the ATC menu right there, and I'm probably just going to turn off to the left and get onto the taxiway. So I'm going to give ourselves a little bit of throttle, and we'll just start turning right away to the left. Not too worried about these clouds that are up there right now. I'm hoping that they are not too low once we get to the Jamestown area, but you can never be so sure. Doing a terrible job taxiing. My rudder pedals just seem so sensitive, so I'm gonna have to probably work on calibrating those as well. All right, I already forgot our passenger's name, but I'm glad you're here on Phriq Airlines with us, flying our beautiful Cessna 172. Why you did this instead of driving is beyond me. Maybe you just like to fly, maybe you had another DUI. I have no idea why anybody would choose to charter a Cessna 152 for a cross country, but you know, odder things have happened in this world. While we taxi, I also want to give a shout out to my good friend Tappers Airlines, who has his own YouTube videos and channel as well. He makes some beautiful fly over the UK videos, so if you want to check him out, I am going to put a link in the description box below. Definitely check him out. He is extraordinarily entertaining, a little quieter, a little more tame than I am, which is absolutely a good thing because no one wants to watch me or listen to me ramble like this for much more than probably like 5 minutes. I'm pretty sure I've already lost half my viewership by this point. If you are still with me, I commend you, sir or ma'am. As you can see, we are already getting towards the end of the taxiway. Right over there is gonna be runway 31. We will get set up to do our run up in just a second. Actually, what I am gonna do is I am gonna start turning to the right, barring that there is no one there that I can crash into, because there is basically no other aircraft at this airport. I am gonna do the run up here in this parking area where we have a lot more space. Seems like a lot safer of a idea than trying to do it on the taxiway. We are gonna do a really sharp turn right here and stop. Close enough, we are pretty much probably facing to the northern direction. We are gonna hit, whoa, where are you? Why are you shutting off? I am gonna hit my parking brake on. As you can see, my brakes are set. Fuel, we are good when it comes to that. We are a little over half tank. We're not gonna be doing much of a flight here. It's a pretty short flight. We should definitely be good. Flight controls are free and correct. As you can see, in, out, right, left, and if I do my rudders, they are working as well. Normally you would look outside, but for speed, I am just pressing on. Instruments are all set on account that there's nothing really to set. Mixture is best power, primer in and locked. We are going to go ahead and push up our power to around 1700 RPM. That way we can check our magnetos and our carb heat, make sure they are functioning properly. As you can see, we are around that 1700 RPM mark. I'm going to drop down to the left magneto. As you can see, a little dip in the RPM right there. We'll go back to both and you will see it rise some. Now we are going to go to the right magneto. You will see it continue to dip, and then we'll go to both and you should see a little bit of a rise. So we know both mags are working. If we pull out our carb heat, that turns it on. And as you can see, there is another dip in the tachometer right there. So we know our carb heat is working as well. Let's go ahead and pull our throttle all the way to idle now, just to make sure that the aircraft works in idle and everything seems to be functioning as we need it to. Gonna push in my throttle just a tiny bit more to get us to that 1000 RPM, and I'm gonna get ready for the pre-takeoff checklist. I'm gonna put my flaps down to 10%. Mixture is at best power, carb heat is off, pitot heat is, well, we don't even have it in this aircraft. Nav lights coming on, landing lights coming on. We're not gonna turn on our dome light. We should be all right with that. Heading indicator to compass, so we want to make sure that those are aligned to make sure they are working. So as you can see, it's showing a 343 heading, and we can see a 343 heading up here as well, so we know both of those are working. Transponder, we are going to be setting that to 1200. We'll go ahead and put that to the on position at this time. Landing lights are also on, as I mentioned. We do not have strobes. Time, we can go ahead and note that for when we're doing our takeoff, and also if we were doing timing for our VFR waypoints, which I am not. Hopefully I do not fail. I've never test flighted this flight or anything like that. We're just going for it, but I think we can make it work. Brakes, we are gonna go ahead and release them. We are gonna start taxiing to the active taxiway that we are gonna be using. We are gonna pull up the ATC menu. We are gonna announce that we are getting ready for takeoff, runway 31. Let's announce our taxi, I suppose. I don't think anybody is in the area flying here. No one's wanting to fly with all that COVID's junk going on and things like that. So I'm pretty sure we have the sky to ourselves. We're going to stop at the hold short line here, even though we are good stewards of aviation. So let's go ahead and hit those brakes, even though we're going a little fast for that. Let's look out the right wing. I'm not seeing any aircraft. We'll look out the left wing, not seeing any aircraft. So let's announce our takeoff departure to the south. All right, Miss Passenger, who I already forgot your name, I hope your Walleye and Northern are stowed safely in the back luggage compartment. We are ready for takeoff. We are going to be taking off on runway 31. We will be turning south and flying over Devil's Lake, and hopefully we can get you to Jamestown, North Dakota in 37 minutes because we haven't even taken off yet. So we're just going to get right into it. Takeoff, we're going to go to full RPM. RPM is going to be between, or hopefully above 2,280. We're going to put in our rudder and get us ready for this takeoff. Already at 60 knots, we can go ahead and start to rotate, and we should slowly start to lift off the ground, and there we go. Look at that. Isn't that just beautiful? I love it when things work out the way they are supposed to work out, instead of having terrible engine fires and engine disasters right on takeoff. We've got a good speed. I'm going to go ahead and put up those flaps to try to get a little more speed. And I'm already just going to start my turn off to the south. There is no one in the area. We should definitely be all right to do that. Start rotating us out of that turn. There we go. And as you can see, we are flying roughly a heading of 160, so not quite where we want to be going, but it's all right if we go a little bit to the east more than we want. I'm gonna look up because it was kind of hard to see how I was climbing in that view. Like I said, I'm gonna be climbing up to 5,500 feet. And we are going to be crossing over beautiful, lovely Devil's Lake, North Dakota. It is a lovely fishing destination. If you ever get to North Dakota, I recommend coming here. There are lots of walleye, northern pike, crappie, perch, all those delicious fish that you might like to eat. One downside with this lake, I have fished it before, a couple times actually, is it is rather large. My boat's only a 16-foot boat, and the problem with that is, because it is so big, even a 10-mile-an-hour wind can make your boat rock quite a bit, actually, especially in the open water. Luckily, I normally try to fish, I either fish on the northern shore in some of these outcoves right here. There are bridges that cross some of those. I'm not sure if you can see any of those or not, but the walleye like to sit out in those areas, and they are delicious. I highly recommend, if you have never had walleye, definitely try to get some walleye. Trying to maintain that 170, I keep on turning a little bit to the left, I guess, darn P-factor and torque and all that aerodynamical stuff, but whatever. We will get on course and we should be good. As you can see, we are slowly climbing out. We are just about to hit 3,000 feet. We're gonna have another 2,500 feet in the climb. Luckily today, another thing I'm noticing is we are not having mass amounts of turbulence because of all the wind. That is beautiful. Hopefully this will just be a nice smooth sailing flight the entire way. We'll make it just before dark and we will have an extraordinarily fun time doing it. That is the plan at least. We'll see how it goes. We are going to tune to Minneapolis Center on 124.2 and request a flight following as well. So let's go ahead and do that. Five six zero five. Let's go ahead and acknowledge radar contact. Make sure we are on 2978, which it appears that we are, so we are set there. As you can see, we're still flying, well, around that 160, so we are getting a little more to the east than I would like, so we will start to turn and maybe just go south for a little bit right here. Even if we do head completely south, we will see the Jamestown Reservoir and still see those lakes off to our east, which is going to be our left wing, so I'm not too concerned about any of that. We should definitely be able to make it safely. Gonna get rid of that ATC window again and start looking around it. Here you can see lovely Devil's Lake, North Dakota. What I think I'm gonna do is actually pause for the rest of the climb, and I will bring you back in just a little bit, but hopefully you guys can see some lovely sights as I do that. So I will talk to you all in just a little bit. Everybody, I am back. Say goodbye to lovely Devil's Lake, North Dakota. Hopefully we will return soon, and as we do, let's get back on course, because I was outside of the aircraft again on the wing and not seeing that we were turning quite as much as we were, trying to avoid that to the best of my ability. As you can see, we have just passed 5,000. We're going to be beginning our level off here in just a moment, and then we will get set for cruise. The climb checklist on this aircraft is basically climb at 70 to 80 knots, power mixture instruments, taxi landing lights off. I'm gonna have the landing light on below 10,000 feet. Flight plan, we can go ahead and open that, which we're not really doing because we're flying VFR. So that is the entire climb out checklist. The cruise checklist in preparation for that is gonna be setting our throttle, our mixture instruments, and heading to compass. Just make sure that is all checking as well. As far as the instruments go, we are not setting any nav frequencies. We are just on with Minneapolis Center, and we are flying strictly VFR. We do have a separate squawk code for that flight following, however. So we are about 100 feet away from our 5,500 foot mark, so we're going to begin our level out in just a second. This aircraft is not climbing terribly, terribly fast. So we are gonna basically start to level out right now. So for that, I am gonna slowly start dipping the nose down, start tripping in that forward pressure, trimming in that, did I say tripping? Trimming in that forward pressure. On that way, once we release, we hopefully will be at a nice level. As you can see, I am not touching the controls right now, and we are still climbing a tiny bit, so let's go ahead and put a little more forward pressure in and trim that in as well. With that, we are gonna see our airspeed start to climb. I am gonna keep full throttle the entire time, so hopefully we don't run into any issues with that. I am gonna lean back the mixture just a little bit, and as you can see, the RPMs actually grew slightly by that, just because we have a little less oxygen up in this thinner atmosphere. Starting to get a little high because I'm looking at some other instrumentation, so we are gonna get us back to altitude, get us trimmed out, and hopefully we can fly this for the majority of the time hands-free, and just kind of enjoy the southerly flight that we are going to be doing into the sun-setting sky. All these clouds are above us, so hopefully they don't lower as we get towards that Jamestown area, but we will have to check on that as well. Still a little high, so I'm just going to push down a little more on my yoke. We're going to get some faster airspeed here. Going to keep an eye on that, making sure we don't get too fast, but we're only descending about 100 feet, so we should be all right. As you can see, once I started to level off, it wanted to rise some, so we're going to trim in some of that forward pressure, and now we will start to level off at that 5,500 feet. So we are looking good right now. Off to our left, you can see all those little lakes that I was talking about. That is what our first visual points are going to be. We're just going to make sure those stay off to our right wing. As you can see, there are a couple individual ones off to the right, but it is nothing like off the left wing. So that is our first major visual cue as we keep flying south. As you can see, we are on more of a southerly heading right now as opposed to a 170 heading, but you know, I can deal with that. This aircraft does not want to trim very well. I gotta fix the sensitivity as well on my trim wheel, because it seems like in order to trim it just a hair, I have to like do a full circle on it, and definitely it should not act that insensitive. It's so insensitive. This is kind of like your ex-girlfriend, this trim wheel. It's just insensitive, doesn't care about your feelings. It wants you to cater to it all of the time. Hopefully, we can get this figured out in some of our future flights. With that said, I'm just going to work on maintaining that 5,500 feet and flying roughly as we are doing at that 85 knots, and hopefully we'll get there in the next 23 minutes. We might be a little late on this one just because we had to circle around and we had to do all our taxiing and stuff like that once she was aboard. So, I forgot to account for the engine run-up as well, so hopefully we can make up a little bit of time in this flight. With that being said, I'm probably going to pause the video here for just a couple minutes so you can see more of the lovely landscape of North Dakota and all its farmland beauty. There are so many trees in my scenery mod. I am going to have to reduce that as well because North Dakota does not have this many trees. I mean, North Dakota is flat, treeless, and it is so windy because Montana blows and Minnesota sucks. Just kidding, I like both of those states, but yeah, we are a windy state and have very little as far as exciting terrain. It's mostly farmland, especially here on the east central side of North Dakota. With that, I am really gonna pause this time, so I will bring you all back in just a little bit. Everybody, I am back. As you can see, I'm still flying 5,500, but the clouds are starting to get a little lower over here, and we don't want to get into those, so I'm actually going to start a descent and start flying at 3,500. So we're going to start dipping our nose down some. We are going to pull back our power just a little bit, and we are going to fly down to around 3,500 because we got to avoid these clouds on account that we are just flying strictly VFR. Charlie, Juliet, Romeo 5, airport. pull back my throttle a little more and get a little quicker of a descent going, because, well, we don't want to... We want to descend before we get into these clouds here, but we also want to make sure that we are not overspeeding the aircraft at the same time. However, this descent will help speed us up in the short term. Just past, I don't know if you can see it over there, but another lake. Everything still seems to be heading okay. Right now we are flying roughly at around that kind of 160, 170, hopefully, kind of heading right now as well. 171 is what it is showing. So we'll continue this descent down to 3,500 so we can stay under the clouds. We don't want to get locked in above them or anything like that. That would not be good. I was noticing that it was starting to get a little more difficult to see the horizon outside. It was harder to maintain altitude because of that, because I wasn't really sure exactly where the horizon was. So that's another kind of gotcha that you might be heading into some clouds. Especially, they get a little harder to see their altitudes when you are getting close to dusk. Just because the sky starts to wash out some of the colors and everything turns to that more orangish gray, so you can't necessarily always tell where they start, especially when they are in front of you. So that's one thing that we just wanted to make sure we avoided. Another thing is, I'm pretty sure we are going to be late. That is all right. I can handle that. But you know, something to look out for while you are flying, making sure that you correctly think of the times that you are going to need in order to get to a certain location. Hopefully we won't be too late. Looks like we might actually, I can't tell, nope, that's just something on the windshield right there. Couldn't tell if that was a lake coming up or if that was just glare off the windshield. Got another probably around 300 feet left in our descent. Hopefully this is going to be low enough, otherwise we are going to be getting mighty close to the ground. We did run into one tiny bit of turbulence, so you can see her satisfaction's at 97% instead of that stellar 100 that we were hoping for, but you know, overall it has been relatively smooth the entire time. And yes, it does look like you can start to see the James River, or the, well, it's the James River into the Jamestown Reservoir right up there, so that is excellent as well. We are leveling out now at 3,500 feet, so we're going to maintain that altitude. Hopefully we stay below these clouds here. It doesn't look like it's a thick layer, and it looks like we could have maybe stayed above them and got to the other side, but when you're flying VFR, that's one thing you never want to have happen, is get sandwiched between multiple layers of clouds, because you don't know how far those extend in front of you, and if your destination is below, then you're going to either be breaking VFR flight rules by flying through the clouds, or you are going to be, you know, stuck in between the clouds and possibly having to turn around. And since we did not bring an excess of fuel this time, that is something that I wanted to avoid. I'm debating whether I still want to descend a little further just because these clouds might be ahead of us, so that might be something that we are going to be looking into as well. It's kind of hard. I think I am going to be breaking my visual flight rule cruising altitudes, and we're just probably going to cruise at around maybe 2,500 just so we can stay below these. Altitude here is roughly at most, I think, 1,000 feet. I'm going to pull up AirNav for Jamestown and see if we can find out what the altitude or the elevation is for that airport. It is 1,500 feet, so we definitely don't want to get too low, but 2,500 feet is absolutely okay. You can absolutely fly 1,000 feet above ground. However, when you are doing that, you gotta be pretty cognizant of where you are going, because you wanna make sure that there are no obstructions in the way. As you can see, there are a bunch of towers over here. Some of them go up to 1,843, which would be, well, they're not too high. I guess we'd still be 1,000 feet above them. I'm not seeing really anything out here. 2,200 is kind of the highest obstacle in our way. So if we level off at 2,500, we should definitely be all right. However, this lower altitude is going to make it a little more difficult to see where the airport is, just because we're not going to be able to see just as far in front of us as we would like. But I think we are actually getting pretty close to Jamestown as is. I don't see the airport yet. I will keep looking for that. That is not Jamestown right there. You are an imposter town. I am not sure who you are. With that being said, I am going to continue my descent. I am going to be continuing following the Jamestown Reservoir over here south until hopefully next time we see Jamestown Airport in the field of view. It might actually even be right up here. I thought I saw a light, but maybe I am just seeing stuff. But we will continue to fly, and we will bring you back as we get a little closer to Jamestown, and we can start our descent and planning for landing into Jamestown Regional Airport in Jamestown, North Dakota. So I will see you all back in just a little bit. Everybody, I am back. As you can see throughout the videos that I was showing you, and right now we are still following along the Jamestown Reservoir, but it looks like I can start to see the city of Jamestown up here with the airport right ahead of us. So we should be able to land there. We are running behind. Hopefully we'll be able to land within the next 10 minutes or so. But while we do that, what I'm going to do is start preparing for that. So I'm going to cancel my flight following. We're going to go to the nearest airport list, and we're going to go to Jamestown Regional, and we are going to turn to the automated weather. Weather seems not too bad, so we're going to turn to the Jamestown CTAF frequency. Winds are only 274 at 4, which is not bad at all. I can see the runway lights up here. We're going to plan to land on runway 31, which is their main runway. And so for that, we are going to have to circle around. As you can see, we can see the runway lights for the other ones. Right here should be runway 13 and or runway 31, the reciprocal of it. So yay. Everything looks like we are heading on nicely. So what I'm going to do is start slowing us down to get prepared for this landing. I'm going to pull back my throttle some, but maintain this altitude of 2,500 feet. We're going to have a little bit of a crosswind, but winds are only 4 nautical miles, so I am not too concerned with that. As we start to slow down, once we get into the traffic pattern, we are going to get set with our flaps. Let's select a runway for landing. It's going to be runway 31, and we will announce our position right now, maybe, if we can. Oh, full stop landing we need to do and announce our position. All right, we have selected that we are inbound to land runway 31. I can see runway 13 right here, so we are gonna circle around that. We're just gonna enter into a left downwind. Not hearing any other traffic and or seeing any other traffic, so we definitely should be good to go with that. Gonna close out of that as of right now, and then we'll announce our down leg and base leg, as well as our final. Pull back my throttle a little more. Start to slow us down. And we are hitting Jamestown right before dusk, which is kind of nice. Gonna fly this pattern at 2,400 feet, which should be about 1,000 feet above the airfield. Let's go ahead and announce that we are entering the downwind leg. It's kind of a long downwind, but you know. We'll announce it a little early. No one else is in the pattern. No other traffic is present that I can see. Are starting to get a little low, so I'm gonna start to pull up some, and I am gonna add my first detent of flaps. That's gonna help us climb just a little bit. And I will use that ballooning, but make sure that we don't descend any further. Gonna add in a little more power so we don't get too slow. And we should be on downwind. We can make sure that we are on the right runway heading as well, because we should be doing the reciprocal, which is runway 13. We are deviating slightly from it, but you can see we're on a 140 heading, so we know that that one right there is 13. Also, we can see that this is runway 4. Little look at the city of Jamestown just off our right wing. All those beautiful lights that are extraordinarily bright, lighting up pretty beautifully. Looks pretty nice at this time of night. Jamestown is an airport that I have flown into real world quite a few times, actually. I am familiar with this town, another reason I wanted to fly into it, and hopefully we can just enjoy a nice smooth landing as we go into runway 31. Check our altitude. We are starting to get a little on the low side, so I'm gonna start to climb just a bit. Not too much. We can do a nice low approach on this, I suppose. Give ourselves some full power right now just to get a little higher. We do have some traffic ahead of us, so we'll keep an eye on them. We are getting far enough out, so I'm gonna announce that we are on base leg. Get rid of that for right now.
sure where that runway is. Hopefully we start to see it soon. There we go. And I'm just going to announce that we are on final and get rid of that. We are showing that we are a little high, so I'm going to start to descend, pull back my throttle some, get us onto a nice little glide path. We are going in pretty fast, so I'm going to pull back the throttle even more because we are going to be descending and we are going a little fast. Not much wind, so hopefully this will be a nice smooth landing. As you can see, we are arriving about 11 minutes late, so we are going to get docked for that. That is unfortunate, but that is one of those things. I just did not think of the run-up that we were going to have to do and also account for the time that it was going to take us to have to do the circling around Devil's Lake. We also deviated a little bit far to the west on our flight path, but whatever. I will take that. So far, I am pretty happy with this flight. Gotta get used to my controls. Trying to set a nice, this trim just does not want to trim in the way I want it to. I have to turn it so much. Give myself a little right rudder to align with. Start pulling that out as we are right on center line, and we will start to cut our power. And we are down. Pretty decent landing that time. Definitely can always improve upon all of your landings. Pulling up the airport diagram for Jamestown. Looks like I am going to be getting off on the next runway, or I could have probably turned there. But, whoops, where am I? Can't even turn left to see. Could have probably just turned off there, but we're gonna get off on this next runway up here, which will definitely be all right as well. Give myself a little more power. There is no other taxiway unless I go way past this other runway, but real world, I have used it as a taxiway before. Actually, this might just be a taxiway, which works out. All right, we are clear of the active. The nice little terminal right up ahead of us, I'm gonna go ahead and announce that we are clear of the active.
Mike Sierra, traffic, Papa Hotel, Quebec 3-4, is clear of the runway.
Look both ways, there is a taxiway there. That first one was really short, that would have been A1. This is taxiway, it should be taxiway Bravo. It's showing Charlie, which I'm not even seeing on this airport diagram, so I don't even know what runway this, or taxiway this is. But I'm seeing that Echo is right there, so I do know where that is. So everything is looking all right. We are actually going to turn to our right. We're not going to go to the main terminal. We're going to go to the FBO, which is right over here. Fueling should be off to our left, where that giant red beacon tower is. But we're just going to park right around here. Come to these hangars right over here. This, well, we'll say that's going to be the FBO. So there should be some parking up here for us to utilize. At least that is the plan, and I hope it pans out.
Anyway, if you've made it this far in the video, I want to thank you very much for watching this video, and I hope you enjoyed the flight. I hope you learned something. I always try to make these fairly realistic, so hopefully you are getting something out of them. If I screwed anything up, definitely call me out, because sometimes I do miss things and it's not something that I'm proud of, but hey, no one is perfect. Also, if you like the videos, please subscribe, please send me your comments and your messages. I would appreciate those greatly. Also, if you do subscribe, ring that notification bell so that way you can get notifications on when I come out with my new videos as well. Also, like I mentioned before, check out my friend Tapper's Airlines. He makes some great UK flying videos, and I absolutely highly recommend you all go check him out as well. I'm gonna pull into this first parking spot right up here, so I'll just give myself a little more power. Make it around this turn, and we will get this passenger off so she can get back home and show her family all the delicious fish that she caught. So I'm gonna go ahead and park right there. Throttle is idle. I'm gonna go ahead and pull on to my parking brake to make sure that that is set. Going into my checklist, we have the flaps still down some, so we're gonna go ahead and put those up. Carb heat is off. Strobes, we'll go ahead and just turn off all our lights at this time. And as we do that, we are gonna pull back our mixture and kill the engine. We had no pitot heat. Trim, we'll set that for takeoff again. So we'll go ahead and just get that ready for our next flight. Transponder, we can go ahead and put on to standby, and I'll just turn it off at this point. We are going to turn off our master switches as well. Securing, we want to make sure our avionics are off, which got turned off with our master switches. Mags are off right now. Master switches are off, lights are off. We can record our Hobbs and tack time, see how much time we put on the engine. Control lock, we'll go ahead and do that. Chocks tie downs, pedal covers, and cabin doors. So let's go ahead and open our door and let our passenger off. Thanks for flying with us on Phriq Airlines. I hope you guys enjoyed the flight. Make sure everything is secure and ready for our next flight. It looks that way, so I'm going to close the door now that she... Oh, she's still on board. Whoops. Sorry. Hope I didn't cut off your leg. My bad. She still has 16 seconds to crawl over my leg. She sounds like she maybe had a few too many drinks, because whatever I just heard there was indistinguishable from the human language. She is off the aircraft at this time, so let's go ahead and close the door at this time, and we will go into FS Passengers and end this flight. As you can see, it was a normal flight. It has already been registered. We flew 71 nautical miles, landing speed was 55, and our landing touchdown was a kiss. Everything appeared to be good there. Very good flight, professionally done, 97%. That is good to hear. Considering the flight was very good, the ticket prices were low, she thinks our reputation should be 97. Your company reputation is now 73.43. We did get a few bonuses. We made a very smooth landing. Good flight, no problems, and satisfied passengers. And you landed at the scheduled airport. However, I did not get that bonus for landing at the correct time. Anyway, that is the end of the flight. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thanks again for tuning in with me. We will see you all next week for episode 4. And if you're wondering when I'm going to be getting another aircraft, I'm probably going to just do one more flight with the Cessna 152, and then we're probably going to upgrade. I'm not exactly sure what I'm going to be upgrading to, because I do plan on flying a wide variety of aircraft, so I might go into a 172, and then after that go into a Piper for a little while. So we will look forward to that in the future. Again, thanks for watching. Please subscribe, please comment, please send me your messages, and ring that notification bell, and I will see you all next time.